In Unit 5 of this course, you will learn about techniques to aid in the organization and day-to-day management of your site. There are two basic goals we want to accomplish here. First, to make life easier on your users by providing them with functional, consistent navigation and dynamic content to keep them interested in coming back. And second, to make life easier on you, the site publisher, by giving you access to scripting technologies that can simplify site maintenance. As a critical first step, you'll discover the basics of usability. Usability is a term that gets thrown around a lot these days, but what does it really mean? Obviously, you want to adhere to generally accepted web conventions so that people trying to get at information on your site won't end up tearing out their own hair in frustration. Clearly, your own intuition is a good start, but it's not nearly enough. So, we need to conduct a little experiment. The best way to gauge a site's usability is to round up a group of people who are representative of your target audience, have them use your site one at a time, and then record what difficulties they encountered in executing basic tasks. In this unit, we'll turn to the father of usability, Jacob Nielsen, to tell us all about it. In Unit 3, you learn to create a style sheet by inserting the style tag into your web pages. In this unit, you'll create an external style sheet. This is a style sheet that exists in a completely separate document from any web code, and the XHTML docs you create merely link to it. This can be amazingly helpful in keeping a consistent style across pages, as well as easily updating the site's look. After all, within an external style sheet, you need only change the style in one place, and the aesthetics are updated throughout the whole site. In this unit, we'll learn how, starting by prettying up our navigation. Of course, with an increasing demand for online interactivity, websites typically get a lot more complicated than just HTML and CSS. The next part of this unit will focus on the different kinds of scripting that make technologies like search fields, web logs, and online databases able to work their magic. After learning to recognize these techniques, you'll be given a tiny coding task of your own, using JavaScript to create a pop-up alert box. And in the conclusion of this unit, you'll learn about validating your work. Earlier in the course, we talked a lot about the standards put forth by the W3C, and in this unit, we'll put our XHTML and CSS code to the test by seeing how well it adheres to those standards. By keeping to the rules established by the W3C, you can help ensure that work will display consistently across virtually all browsers and platforms. As a final touch, we'll also look at tools for evaluating our site's level of accessibility.